بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم رب شهر رمضان الذي أنزلت فيه القرآن وافترضت على عبادك فيه الصيام صل على محمد وآل محمد وارزقني حج بيتك الحرام في عامي هذا وفي كل عام واغفر لي تلك الذنوب العظام فإنه لا يغفرها غيرك يا رحمن يا علام بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم إني أفتتح الثناء بحمدك وأنت مسدد للصواب بمنك وأيقنت أنك أنت أرحم الراحمين في موضع العفو والرحمة وأشد المعاقبين في موضع النكال والنقمة وأعظم المتجبرين في موضع الكبرياء والعظمة اللهم أذنت لي في دعائك ومسألتك فاسمع يا سميع مدحتي وأجب يا رحيم دعوتي وأقل يا غفور عثرتي فكم يا إلهي من كربة قد فرجتها وهموم قد كشفتها وعثرة قد أقلتها ورحمة قد نشرتها وحلقة بلاء قد فككتها الحمد لله الذي لم يتخذ صاحبة ولا ولدا ولم يكن له شريك في الملك ولم يكن له ولي من الذل وكبره تكبيرا الحمد لله بجميع محامده كلها على جميع نعمه كلها الحمد لله الذي لا مضاد له في ملكه ولا منازع له في أمره الحمد لله الذي لا شريك له في خلقه ولا شبيه له في عظمته الحمد لله الفاشي في الخلق أمره وحمده الظاهر بالكرم مجده الباسط بالجود يده الذي لا تنقص خزائنه ولا تزيده كثرة العطاء إلا جودا وكرما إنه هو العزيز الوهاب اللهم إني أسألك قليلا من كثير مع حاجة بي إليه عظيمة وغناك عنه قديم وهو عندي كثير وهو عليك سهل يسير اللهم إن عفوك عن ذنبي وتجاوزك عن خطيئتي وصفحك عن ظلمي وسترك على قبيح عملي وحلمك عن كثير جرمي عندما كان من خطئي وعمدي أطمعني في أن أسألك ما لا أستوجبه منك الذي رزقتني من رحمتك وأريتني من قدرتك وعرفتني من إجابتك فصرت أدعوك آمنا وأسألك مستأنسا لا خائفا ولا وجلا مدلا عليك فيما قصدت فيه إليك فإن أبطأ عني عتبت بجهلي عليك ولعل الذي أبطأ عني هو خير لي لعلمك بعاقبة الأمور فلم أر مولا كريما أصبر على عبد لئيم منك علي يا ربي إنك تدعوني فأولي عنك وتتحبب إلي فأتبغض إليك وتتودد إلي فلا أقبل منك كأن لي التطول عليك فلم يمنعك ذلك من الرحمة لي والإحسان إلي والتفضل علي بجودك وكرمك فارحم عبدك الجاهل وجد عليه بفضل إحسانك إنك جواد كريم الحمد لله مالك الملك مجري الفلك مسخر الرياح فالق الإصباح ديان الدين رب العالمين الحمد لله على حلمه بعد علمه والحمد لله على عفوه بعد قدرته والحمد لله على طول أناته في غضبه وهو قادر على ما يريد الحمد لله خالق الخلق باسط الرزق فالق الإصباح ذي الجلال والإكرام والفضل والإنعام الذي بعد فلا يرى وقرب فشهد النجوى تبارك وتعالى الحمد لله الذي ليس له منازع يعادله ولا شبيه يشاكله ولا ظهير يعاضده قهر بعزته الأعزاء وتواضع لعظمته العظماء فبلغ بقدرته ما يشاء الحمد لله الذي يجيبني حين أنادي ويستر علي كل عورة وأنا أعصيه ويعظم النعمة علي فلا أجازي فكم من موهبة هنيئة قد أعطاني وعظيمة مخوفة قد كفاني وبهجة مؤنقة قد أراني فأثني عليه حامدا وأذكره مسبحا الحمد لله الذي لا يهتك حجابه ولا يغلق بابه ولا يرد سائله ولا يخيب آمنه الحمد لله الذي يؤمن الخائفين وينجي الصالحين ويرفع المستضعفين ويضع المستكبرين ويهلك ملوكا ويستخلف آخرين والحمد لله قاسم الجبارين مبير الظالمين مدرك الهاربين نكال الظالمين صريخ المستصرخين موضع حاجات الطالبين معتمد المؤمنين الحمد لله الذي من خشيته ترعد السماء وسكانها وترجف الأرض وعمارها وتموج البحار ومن يسبح في غمراتها الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله الحمد لله الذي يخلق ولم يخلق ويرزق ولا يرزق ويطعم ولا يطعم ويميت الأحياء ويحيي الموتى وهو حي لا يموت بيده الخير وهو على كل شيء قدير اللهم صل على محمد عبدك ورسولك وأمينك وصفيك وحبيبك وخيرتك من خلقك وحافظ سرك ومبلغ رسالاتك أفضل وأحسن وأجمل وأكمل وأزكى وأنمى وأطيب وأطهر وأسنى وأكثر ما صليت وباركت وترحمت وتحننت وسلمت على أحد من عبادك وأنبيائك ورسلك وصفوتك وأهل الكرامة عليك من خلقك اللهم وصل على علي أمير المؤمنين ووصي رسول رب العالمين عبدك ووليك وأخي رسولك وحجتك على خلقك وآيتك الكبرى والنبأ العظيم وصل على الصديقة الطاهرة فاطمة سيدة نساء العالمين وصل على سبطي الرحمة وإمامي الهدى الحسن والحسين سيدي شباب أهل الجنة وصل على أئمة المسلمين علي بن الحسين ومحمد بن علي وجعفر بن محمد وموسى بن جعفر وعلي بن موسى ومحمد بن علي وعلي بن محمد والحسن بن علي والخلف الهادي المهدي حججك على عبادك وأمنائك في بلادك صلاة كثيرة دائمة اللهم وصل على ولي أمرك القائم المؤمل والعدل المنتظر وحفه بملائكتك المقربين وأيده بروح القدس يا رب العالمين اللهم اجعله الداعي إلى كتابك والقائم بدينك استخلفه في الأرض كما استخلفت الذين من قبله مكن له دينه الذي ارتضيته له أبدله من بعد خوفه أمنا يعبدك لا يشرك بك شيئا اللهم أعزه وأعزز به وانصره وانتصر به وانصره نصرا عزيزا وافتح له فتحا يسيرا واجعل له من لدنك سلطانا نصيرا اللهم أظهر به دينك وسنة نبيك حتى لا يستخفى بشيء من الحق مخافة أحد من الخلق اللهم إنا نرغب إليك في دولة كريمة تعز بها الإسلام وأهله وتذل بها النفاق وأهله وتجعلنا فيها من الدعاة إلى طاعتك والقادة إلى سبيلك وترزقنا بها كرامة الدنيا والآخرة اللهم ما عرفتنا من الحق فحملنا وما قصرنا عنه فبلغنا اللهم المن به شعثنا واشعل به صدعنا وارتق به فتقنا وكثر به قلتنا وأعزز به ذلتنا وأغن به عائلنا واقض به عن مغرمنا واجبر به فقرنا وسد به خلتنا ويسر به عسرنا وبيض به وجوهنا وفك به أسرنا وأنجح به طلبتنا وأنجز به مواعيدنا واستجب به دعوتنا وأعطنا به سؤلنا وبلغنا به من الدنيا والآخرة آمالنا وأعطنا به فوق رغبتنا يا خير المسؤولين وأوسع المعطين اشف به صدورنا وأذهب به غيظ قلوبنا واهدنا به لما اختلف فيه من الحق بإذنك إنك تهدي من تشاء إلى صراط مستقيم وانصرنا به على عدوك وعدونا إله الحق آمين اللهم إنا نشكو إليك فقد نبينا صلواتك عليه وآله وغيبة ولينا وكثرة عدونا وقلة عددنا وشدة الفتن بنا وتظاهر الزمان علينا فصل على محمد وآل محمد وأعنا على ذلك بفتح منك تعجله وبضر تكشفه ونصر تعزه وسلطان حق تظهره ورحمة منك تجللناها وعافية منك تلبسناها برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم برحمتك في الصالحين فأدخلنا وفي عليين فارفعنا وبكأس من معين من عين سلسبيل فاسقنا ومن الحور العين برحمتك فزوجنا ومن الولدان المخلدين كأنهم لؤلؤ مكنون فأخدمنا ومن ثمار الجنة ولحوم الطير فأطعمنا ومن ثياب السندس والحرير والاستبرق فألبسنا وليلة القدر وحج بيتك الحرام وقتلا في سبيلك فوفق لنا وصالح الدعاء والمسألة فاستجب لنا وإذا جمعت الأولين والآخرين يوم القيامة فارحمنا وبراءة من النار فاكتب لنا وفي جهنم فلا تغلنا وفي عذابك وهوانك فلا تبتلنا ومن الزقوم والضريع فلا تطعمنا ومع الشياطين فلا تجعلنا وفي النار على وجوهنا فلا تكببنا ومن ثياب النار وسرابيل القطران فلا تلبسنا ومن كل سوء يا لا إله إلا أنت بحق لا إله إلا أنت فنجنا بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أعوذ بجلال وجهك الكريم أن ينقضي عني شهر رمضان أو يطلع الفجر من ليلتي هذه ولك قبلي تبعة أو ذنب تعذبني عليه وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين
الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى أما بعد. Dear brothers and sisters in Iman, today we have eighth presentation on 8th of this blessed month, and in last one or two days, actually yesterday, I received more questions and requests that when we were speaking about the importance of dhikr, then some brothers and sisters requested that if we can say a few words more about dhikr, and particularly if we can recommend them some adhkar and some dhikr so they can start doing that dhikr. So answering that request, I will dedicate today's presentation to that subject. And we begin with the Surah Al-Ahzab, chapter 33 and ayat 41, which explains that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding us to remember Him and remember Him much and remember Him abundantly and glorify Him in the morning and in the evening. So Surah Al-Ahzab, chapter 33, ayat 41, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu, Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu dhkurullaha dhikran kathira wasabbihuhu bukratan wa asila. O believers, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala abundantly, dhikran kathira, remember Him much, wasabbihuhu bukratan wa asila, and glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the mornings and in the evenings. Begin your day by glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and conclude your day by glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then in the same surah, we have another verse, which is verse number 35. And if you look at the last one or two sentences of that, it's a relatively a longer verse in Surah Al-Ahzab, chapter 33 and verse 35. Just the ending part of that verse is وَذَّاكِرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَذَّاكِرَاتِ أَعَدَّ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةً وَأَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving a list of those people that who have high ranking with Him, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared forgiveness and high rewards for them. And among that list, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَذَّاكِرِينَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا وَذَّاكِرَاتِ, and those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala much, men and women both. Allah has mentioned dhakirin and dhakirat both. Kathira, they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala much. Then also in Surah An-Nisa, which is chapter 4, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has reminded us that when it comes to remembering Allah, it's not only on any certain time. Salat has its own prescribed timings. And similarly, fasting, wajib fasting, there is a specified time, the month of Ramadan. Similarly, there is a specified time for Hajj. But when it comes to dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is no specified time. Day and night, morning and evening, any time. And in this ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا وَعَلَىٰ جُنُوبِكُمْ, meaning remember Allah in any condition, in any time and anywhere. فَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala while you are standing, remember Him while you are sitting, and remember Him while you are reclining and laying down on your side, left or right, or on your back while you are lying down, or you are standing, or you are sitting. Remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whenever you get the chance. And then this dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, when we are talking about dhikr, the best dhikr is the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is also the ayat of Quran, where Allah says in chapter 29, ayat 45, wala dhikrullahi akbar, wala dhikrullahi akbar, the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is akbar. Akbar is superlative degree, yani the greatest dhikr and the best dhikr of all adhkar and every dhikr, that is dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have a riwayat from Amirul Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salatu was salam, where he says, Dhakirullahi subhanahu mujalisuhu, anyone who sits or who stands and he is doing dhikr of Allah, actually he is in company of Allah. Mujalisuhu, he is companion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So by doing dhikr, we enter into the company of Allah, and while we are doing dhikr, we are companion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So whenever we want to enter in the company of Allah, the key is dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here we begin dhikr, and here we are in the company of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, as I had mentioned day before yesterday, that dhikr has many types, but the main two types of dhikr are dhikr-e-qalbi and dhikr-e-lisani. These are the two major types. Dhikr, which we do by our heart, and dhikr, which we do by our tongue. Dhikr by our heart or by our mind is that we, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in our thoughts and in our mind. We are mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the fact that we are in His presence. This is also called dhikr. We remember Allah. And then this dhikr, that He is in our mind, He is in our thoughts, and we feel and believe that we are in His presence wherever we are. We are in His presence. And if we have this, then of course this dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep us away from the sinful activities, from committing the crimes, or from doing any wrongful activities, because we know Allah is watching us, we are in His presence, and while we are in the company and the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we can't do those things. So that is dhikr-e-qalbi, and that is very important. We need to develop slowly that kind of situation and that kind of condition, that we every time whether it is day or night and wherever we are, every time we have this feeling that we are in presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is one kind of dhikr. But today the question is about dhikr lisani, the dhikr which we do by our tongue. And those azkar, we have thick books written by ulama, our scholars in the area of spirituality and worship and ibadat. And they have listed so many of those adhkar from Quran and Hadith and from the riwayat of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salatu wassalam. And I am just sharing with you some very brief adhkar, very selected one, those adhkar which are agreed upon among the scholars, and also those azkar which are considered the best ones. So only those few azkar, inshallah, I will share with you. And we begin with the dhikr which comes in the beginning, and it is very important and it is highly emphasized, and that is Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. This Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, it has the name of Allah, and then it has those virtues and those qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sifat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, according to many riwayat, is the best verse of Quran. And this dhikr, if people do it by keeping their heart and mind in it, and if they continuously do this dhikr over the period of time, they see this is just kind of like Ism-e-A'zam. Just they say Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim and they get what they want. But of course it comes over the time when we develop that attachment with this zikr, when we do this zikr on regular basis and we develop that kind of spiritual condition, and then we say Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, and here we get what we want. So this dhikr, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, is highly emphasized dhikr. And it is highly recommended that whatever we do, we should first say Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, and then we start whatever we want to do. And if we do that, we make sure first of all that whatever we do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses that action, and we get the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that particular task, for that particular action, and we get success in that undertaking. And also this Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, if we say that in the beginning of every action, you will imagine that how many times in one day we will end up saying Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. For example, this was the sunnat of Prophet, that whenever he would get up from his sleep and he would sit down, or just when he would get up, the first thing what he would say, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. So just when you get up, then of course when you go to washroom, you open the door, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. You do your wudu, you first say Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, and then you start wudu. Then when you come for the prayer, of course you are going to begin with your prayer and with your surah, hamd and any other surah, with Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Then later on, for example, you pick the Quran, you are opening the Quran, you are saying Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, and then you are reciting Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim when you are formally reciting any surah. Similarly, when you are going for your breakfast, you sit on the table, you want to start eating, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim in the beginning. You want to go and dress up, so Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. You are, for example, you just go and you want to turn on your laptop, your computer, first time in the morning you are starting it, so Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, and then you are turning it on your computer, for example. I'm just giving you the example. And then similarly, when we get ready, when we are going out from our home, again, when Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, you open the door of your car, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. You turn on your car, you put the key and you turn on the car, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. So whatever we are doing, just saying Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim doesn't take much time. But if we get habit of saying Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim like that, with whatever action we do here and there, now can you imagine that in one day how many times you had the opportunity of doing dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seeking the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on daily basis, until you go to your bed and here you enter in your bed, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, and then you sit in your bed or you lie down in your bed. So that one zikr is Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. All of us, we should, whenever we open the door, we close the door, whenever we open the book, whenever we start writing and doing those things here and there, there are so, for every task, for every action, small or big, get habit of doing it with saying Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. After that, the dhikr which is mentioned on the top of the list and has the maximum thawab, that is dhikr of La ilaha illallah. La ilaha illallah. We have riwayat from Imam Muhammad al-Baqir alayhi salatu wassalam, where he says that no dhikr has more thawab than the dhikr of La ilaha illallah. He says, if you want to get the maximum sawab and barakat and blessing, then get habit of repeating this dhikr as much as you can. La ilaha illallah. And this is the dhikr, if you remember, 8th Imam Ali ibn Musa al-Ridha alayhi salatu wassalam, when he was being taken to Marv and he entered in the city of Nishapur, and a big number of those scholars of Ahlul Sunnah, they had requested Imam alayhi salatu wassalam for a hadith, and that is a long story and we don't have the time to narrate all of it. But Imam alayhi salatu wassalam, after mentioning that I heard from my father and my father had heard from his father and he heard from his father, and then he says finally that Amirul Mu'mineen had heard from the Prophet, and Prophet heard from Jibreel, and Jibreel heard from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is Hadith Qudsi, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that kalimato La ilaha illallah hisni, that this kalima, this saying La ilaha illallah, is my fortress, and anybody who enters in this my fortress, wa man dakhala hisni faqad amina min azabi, anyone who enters in my fortress, then he is in my refuge and he is protected from my azab. So 8th Imam selected this dhikr and this hadith Qudsi, and he recited in that particular gathering. And of course, then when people wrote, Imam alayhi salatu wasalam said, walakin bishurutaha, but this zikr has its conditions, wa ana min shurutaha, and I am also one of those conditions. Yani la ilaha illallah again has conditions, and those conditions are, for example, nubuwwat, and then imamat, and being an imam of the time, I am a condition. But that is the detail of that, and zikr is la ilaha illallah. That zikr is mentioned that whenever you are down, whenever you feel that you are going through some hard times, from difficult times, you are being tested and tried, and the time is not good for you, at that time recite la ilaha illallah, la ilaha illallah, and recite it repeatedly, as long as you can recite here and there, and it will uplift you, it will give you spiritually boost and upliftment, and you will inshallah feel much fresh and much stronger and strengthened. Imam Muhammad al-Baqir alayhi salatu wassalam narrates on behalf of his father and from his grandfathers that if anyone recites every day 30 times la ilaha illallahul malikul haqqul mubin, la ilaha illallahul malikul haqqul mubin 30 times on daily basis, this person will get barakat and blessings in his rizq, in his sustenance, in his income, his business will improve, he will get inshallah barakat and get in his business increased, and he will become on his own feet, he will get well established if he says this zikr 30 times on every day. Over the time he will see the benefits of this one, and this zikr helps inshallah in this dunya, and this zikr helps in akhirat also. Then there is a zikr called Subhanallah. Subhanallah, again Imam Ja'far as-Sadiq alayhi salatu wasalam says that after your morning prayer, says Subhanallahil Malikil Quddus, Subhanallahil Malikil Quddus, or Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi, Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi. This is also one of those great azkars which helps you in this dunya, and it helps you in akhirat also. Subhanallahi wa bihamdihi. Another highly recommended zikr is Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, as we know, this Suratul Hamd, which we are reciting every day, this Hamd and Shukr, this is highly recommended, and whenever we accomplish anything, whenever we achieve anything, whenever we receive anything, we should say Alhamdulillah. And again, in daily basis, how many things we receive, how many things we achieve, how many things we complete, how many things we accomplish, so many things. And every time when we finish eating, for example, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, or Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah alladhi at'amana wa asqana, and all, but the minimum Alhamdulillah. And whatever whenever we get the chance, whenever we feel that Alhamdulillah we were blessed and we were fortunate and we got some opportunity, we got some good response from anywhere, we received any good news Alhamdulillah. And then we have a riwayat from Imam Sadiq alayhi salatu wassalam, where he says that if someone says Alhamdulillah kama huwa ahluh or kama huwa ahluhu, Alhamdulillah kama huwa ahluhu, then Imam says you get so much sawab that even angels cannot imagine, and angels cannot even comprehend or cannot write. So you get countless sawab, countless and unlimited sawab, just by saying this one line, Alhamdulillah kama huwa ahluhu. Then another zikr which is highly recommended and is considered one of those best azkars according to the riwayat of Imam Sadiq alayhi salatu wasalam, and he narrated on behalf of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam, that is Allahu Akbar, takbir, Allahu Akbar. So Allahu Akbar and La ilaha illallah, Imam says these are on top of the list. And whenever you get the chance, Allahu Akbar and La ilaha illallah. Then we are fortunate that we are given one tasbih, one line where all these four azkars are put together. And this is called Subhanallahi walhamdulillahi wala ilaha illallahu wallahu akbar. So Subhanallahi walhamdulillahi wala ilaha illallah wallahu akbar, one line. This brings all these arkas together. And if we get a habit, whenever we get chance, whenever we feel that this is the time I should engage in dhikr, I should enter in the company of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I should strengthen my spirit and my spirituality, then start saying this dhikr. This is dhikr of those malaika muqarrabeen, those malaika muqarrabeen who are circling around the arsh of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and those who are circling around al-baytul ma'mur, they are the one who are doing this zikr. This is one of those best azkars. And then the best zikr which A'imma alayhi salatu wasalam have narrated, and they said that was a gift which Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam gave to his beloved daughter Hazrat Fatima Zahra salamullah alayha, and that is tasbih Hazrat Fatima Zahra salamullah alayha. Imam Ja'far as-Sadiq alayhi salatu wasalam says, if I have a choice of offering 1000 rak'at namaz or doing this one tasbih, I prefer doing this one tasbih, and it has more sawab than offering 1000 nawafil. Then there are some azkar which are mentioned in certain conditions, that if you have hajat, if you have any need and you want to get that hajat from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Amirul Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salatu wassalam, he says, open the Quran, recite 100 ayat from anywhere of Quran, doesn't matter this surah or that surah, 100 verses of Quran, and then 7 times says Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, Ya Allah, like that 7 times, and then ask that hajat. You will inshallah get your hajat. Imam Sadiq alayhi salatu wasalam says that when you are sick and when or you have any other hajat, you say 10 times Ya Rabb, Ya Rabb, Ya Rabb, Ya Rabb, Ya Rabb, like that, and then you ask dua. Similarly, when it has come before also, whenever you are feeling down, under stress, have more anxiety, and you feel that you need boost, you need strength, and you need to come out of that, the best thing at that time is saying la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahil aliyyil azim. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billahil aliyyil azim. And if you say that at least 10 times or more, it helps you to come out from that condition, and you feel fresh and you feel now strengthened. And similarly, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, at the end I will say that there is a riwayat from Imam Sadiq alayhi salatu wasalam and from other a'imma, that whenever you are in any difficulty, hardship, you are feeling down, or you have some economical issues, some economical hardships, same zikr, but add, this riwayat says, first Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Say Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billahil aliyyil azim. Again, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, La hawla wa la quwwata illa billahil aliyyil azim. So that is also one of those azkar, which is very important. Ayatul Kursi is another highly recommended zikr. Salawat ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad is also one of those top list adhkar. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. That is a dhikr which even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself and his angels, they do it. So when this is their action, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad, when we say that, even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his angels join us in that action. And dhikr yunusiyya, la ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimeen, is also one of those very recommended azkar. This is a verse of Surah Al-Anbiya, Surah Al-Anbiya, chapter 87, where this dhikr is mentioned in Quran. Similarly, there are some other very brief azkar if you want to do tasbih, like Ya Hayyu Ya Qayyum, or Ya Rahmanu Ya Rahim, or Ya Wahidu Ya Ahad, or Ya Fardu Ya Samad, or Ya Hannanu Ya Mannan, or Ya Dhal Jalali Wal Ikram. So these are the azkar which are very commonly found in the riwayat of Ahlul Bayt alayhimu salatu wassalam. Al Asma'ul Husna, recitation of Quran itself, is considered one of the best azkar. So we can pick and choose or use all these azkar whenever, with a plan, with a our own convenience of time, but we will see the benefit, and we will inshallah get a great benefit. Brothers and sisters, that was it for today. Today's program was sponsored by the families of Brother Zaygham Kazimi and Brother Arif Girniwala. So please recite a salawat for sehat and salamti and khairu barakat for both families. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. And I request you for a Surah Fatiha for the Kulsoom bint Qurban Ali, Ghulam Ali ibn Hassan Ali, Fida Hussain ibn Qurban Ali, Radhiya Ridhvi, and all Mu'mineen and Mu'minat. And particularly today, there was a death in our community, the beloved mother of Brother Wazir Musabji and Brother Mia Ji Musabji. She passed away today. Remember her also in your prayers and include her in this Fatiha as well. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.